already sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
Welcome, I'm Ron Collins.
I'm Sandra Betzina. Today what we're going to do on Power Sewing is show you how we can use border prints. People think that you just use it for a skirt, but I'll show you some different ways that you can get an idea. This coat is Vogue 1262, and I took some of the border and put it on the sleeve.
Now this, you cut away the applique, right?
Right.
And then did you zigzag it on?
Zigzagged it back on.
Did you make the little flowers or the little leaves that went with it?
No, that was already there.
Oh, sweet.
And I did a little bit on the pocket, and then you could see some on the border. And so I just cut all this off, you see, and then on the back, I had a good old time with this.
Oh, you did a stripe of fabric down the center back.
See, and sweet. This was just tart, and it's got this little tuck, so I thought I'd put two eyeballs on there. So, you know, don't be afraid to cut up border prints. Let me show you a couple of ideas. Now, here's one. This is how typically you might think of using one. This is a skirt. And what I did is I also lined it because it's chiffon, and so it's lined in a stretch mesh. What you want to do when you use something sheer is look at it and say, does it still have the same integrity? Because some things you put under it, you're kind of disappointed.
Right.
So see, this one I just used on the bottom.
Okay. Now, did you finish this with a Hong Kong seam finish?
Let's see what I did with that. I think that's the, oh yeah, I think I just turned that one under.
That
and
looks,
so, yeah.
And this, you just did a straight hem on that.
Just
actually
did
on your
twin serge, needle.
Twin
and
needle
then
on your
what I did, if you look at the waist on here, you can't see where the elastic is. I slid the elastic up between the two layers. You see?
Between the lining and
yes.
the skirt. Okay.
See, when it slid it up in there and then sewed underneath the bottom.
And you use that really good non-roll elastic.
Yes.
You love so much.
Yes. Now, here's another border print that they were selling as a skirt, but I turned it into a dress. See, it had this stretchiness at the top, and I just cut it all up and did different parts with it.
Wonderful.
Put some on the sleeve.
Now here you just simply ran that through your serger.
The serger, it was just nothing.
It's just a traditional hem.
Yeah, just your little, the one we use with the fusible thread.
That's wonderful stuff.
Now, let's look, this was one of the things when you get border prints, I would say buy a little bit more than you think you should have. This is a dress, my daughter comes over and she wants me to make her this dress, or we work on it together, which means I'm making it. And so this is, she wants one border going down the side, and you can do this, but you have to check. See, the way she wanted to use it was up and down, and the fabric has no stretch up and down. And she had something for a knit, but she didn't want to use it this way. So we had to make it bigger if we wanted to use it going up and down.
Right.
Or you can, you know, you can make it and cut it off and use it someplace else.
So you basically, what you... It's a good thing to buy extra because you're working basically
That's right.
with a nap. Right?
Yeah, you're just trying to figure. Here's another one. See, this is an example of one.
Oh, this is something.
Isn't this neat? And this one has the selvage on the bottom. So this is obviously one that you would make like in a dress, mm-hmm. something like that, or a blouse. Now, you're going to cut this. You're going to have to cut it in order to have it with the stripes going down on the cross grain. You see, so that
right.
means your pieces are not parallel to the selvage, they're perpendicular.
Exactly.
Now when you do that, it gets really tight. I don't know whether you've ever cut anything on the cross grain, but the back gets really tight. So what I do if I'm going to do that is I take the back pattern piece and I cut it from the shoulder to the hem. Now don't get involved in the neck, and I add a half inch. And you see when I cut two,
right.
now that will give me my inch ease back in. So don't forget to do that because that can be really uncomfortable. I can tell you from experience.
So this is going from the shoulder seam right
yes.
down.
Yes, just in the back.
And what? How do you compensate
okay,
for this extra?
Okay, two ways. I could either run an ease line, if that's what I do in the silk, or I can put a little dart. And you see I just... take it like this right. on the diagonal, and if I added a half inch, I put a little quarter inch dart, and it would be
perfect.
Like 3 1/8, okay? So then, take a look. Now, here's another one. Now, this one I brought back from Ethiopia, and It's got different, it's got this nice border on the bottom.
Oh, well,
this would be the perfect thing to cut up because you don't want necessarily, you could use some of it on the bottom, but you really want to kind of cut it up. You want to make a nice shirt.
And this you could use on
yeah.
the cuff. Or
I know.
The
here's another one.
And some of these fabrics, you might not even have to, well, this one you'd have to hem, but
right.
since sometimes you might find a border that has a real nice clean finish so you don't
have
to.
Oh, yeah, you wouldn't have to. And then another thing you could do sometimes is roll the hem this way and cover it with a piece of ribbon if you wanted to. Now, let's take a look at this one. This I wanted to show you this one because this is not so obvious. And sometimes you have to take a look at it. See here, you've got this here. See that stripe, and you've got this. You've also got, it has a sheen to it, so you have to be careful. You have to cut everything in the one direction. So if I were making a blouse, you see, that could be on the bottom, but I could, technically use it someplace else. What I'm trying to say is don't be afraid to cut the borders off and use them someplace else in the garment. Like I could use that for the collar or the cuffs and make it all in this.
And this is more like panels than a...
That's right. And here is, this is a...
You got a lot of stuff there in your stash.
Well, listen, I'm working through it. This was a piece of fabric from Japan, and it was with the kimonos, they would give you an offer of what things you could choose and what went together. So I just took this long piece and made a scarf out of it. See, it started its
Excellent.
Life kind of like this.
Oh, I
and
see.
That's typical, you know, when you have those rolls from Japanese fabric, they're 13 inches wide.
And this is all, you did
and
you
that's all finished.
That?
That's
salvage. Salvage
which... The only problem with using these, and I do use them, is that you have to make sure that the piece is not bigger than your front. Do you see? Because
right.
they're not very wide. So ideally, you want something with lots of seams, or you could kind of piece it and put some of the border mm-hmm. over it. There are kind of ways that... And then another thing you can do is, here's a little, you can take, people always think about taking, what do you do with borders? You can also get something that goes with it that kind of makes it like a border. And you see, this is the hem is faced on the shorts. And
like a big band put on.
Yeah.
And if the shorts weren't long enough, you could add on to it.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And then I use the same little thing on the pocket and for the belt carriers.
That's a great double welt pocket, Sandra.
You like that?
I do.
You taught me that.
Did I?
Now, here's a border print that's a little more of a challenge. I mean, it's a great print.
It's silk. With no stretch.
No stretch in either direction.
Okay.
So that means we'll have to choose a pattern that's a little bit looser. Also, the selvage is along here. And the pattern goes up and down with the selvage. So what can we do? That means we'll cut it. We can cut it up and down.
But so this is like a big scarf, isn't it?
It's like a big scarf, and it has. So I was able to get two panels, but that's all they had. So I bought a little extra. Do you see? Thinking I may have
it.
To do this. So think about when you're getting something. What if I have to cut another little piece out? What can I do it with?
So what are you planning to make from this?
Well, I'm going to make a blouse.
Okay.
But so what I'm doing is, you see, I decided that this is really nice looking here. And I'm going to make that as the front. But if you look at it, it does have a direction. And that means it has the flower. So that means after I got this laid out, I thought, oh, you got to be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you cut double, see, oh, actually, it's the same on
it's
this
going
side.
In the
so
same
it's good.
Direction.
But you have to make sure. So these are the fronts. And then... This part with this part I made as the sides, okay.
You're using a pattern that has a princess
right.
seam intake. There
and then
go.
I have a little extra for the short sleeve blouse.
So this would be this is your
side front.
Side front.
Side back.
Side back.
Yeah. Okay.
This would be
that's the back.
Back, and this would be the side back. Okay.
This would and that's the front. But what it's, what I have to do is. There's no cutting it on the fold. I have to add a seam allowance
right.
to it. And those are the sleeves. So then, now that's when this comes in. You see, then it has, I'm using this for the front placket, and I put it on the bias, and that for the collar.
Collar band. That's and, that little stand at yeah. Mandarin Con.
And I picked the same weight fabric for this as I did for this.
Now, this you're cutting on the bias.
Right.
Now, would you interface that to take
Definitely.
The bias?
Definitely.
Because that would be
and
a
I'd
challenge.
Also interface it on the bias.
Okay.
Because this has got some body to it. Okay. So just, I guess the moral of the story is don't be afraid to cut it up, because using it just the way it is, you can just make a skirt with a gathered right. waist, and they're usually not very flattering. Well, I hope you like this on Border Prints. We'll see you next time on Power Sewing. I want to tell you a little bit about Power Sewing's history. It actually started out with this book, but it started out a little bit before that. My brother and I each inherited $41,000 when my father died, and this was in 1986. And he used to say to me, Sandra, if you ever have any money, which I doubt, invest in yourself because you're a heck of a hard worker. So I published this book, self-published it, and I spent my whole $41,000. And I remember I printed 15,000 books.
Gosh.
And I had no idea how many 15,000 books were until they arrived at the garage. And did you meet me then?
I met you then. This is what Sandra looked
Which
like
back. Would be the same age that he is now.
You've aged well.
Well, I don't know. I don't like that.
And what's this one?
This one, Fear of Some, because I was meeting a lot of people that said, oh, you know, sewing is just so overwhelming. So I published Fear of Sewing just so they could make a little tablecloth or cover pillows or just make Christmas stockings to wet their feet in. It was really simple. We still have some of these.
Gosh. And then you must love cooking.
Yes. This was David Hill and I, this man I met. He loved to cook, and I did too. And he said, I bet you everybody, all the sewers love to cook. So let's ask them all. So we ask them all for their favorite recipe and their favorite sewing tip. We were surprised. Some of these very famous sewing teachers do not cook at all. Then let's see, the next thing
this,
came.
Your,
oh, yeah, this one.
Your
Rodel.
Patterns.
The other thing is, a lot of the patterns, as you know, if you sew, they're not always what we hope them to be. So I'd get a couple of good patterns, and I'd tell everyone about it, that these worked. And then they take them out of print. And I thought, okay, I am going to publish a book. When people would say that, I'd say, how about if I published a book that had patterns with it, and it told you step by step everything you needed to know, and there weren't any mistakes in the pattern. They said, great. So I published this one. This was Rodel Press, No Time to Sew. They no longer do sewing books, but they sold 150,000 of those.
And this one, you really upped it on this.
Oh,
this
boy.
Is Power Sewing Step by Step.
And I went
it
to work
has
with threads, yeah.
Taunton Press. It has 500 colored photographs. You did some serious
work
behind
this, all the samples.
This,
the
right?
photo shoot for that alone was 3 weeks.
Oh,
it was a
goodness.
Lot. Takes me 2 to 3 years to write a book, I guess because I'm doing other things too.
And I think a lot of people that sew for themselves also sew for the home.
Well, actually, I wanted to do a book on fabric, on fit, I think it was, fit and fabric, and Taunton Press wanted to have a book out on home deck. So I said, I will write one if you'll put me together with somebody who's actually in the home deck business, because I want to know how to make those $150 pillows and how to make those draperies. And so I made every single one of the samples in here.
And
it's really is a good book.
Great photography, well detailed.
And everything works because I made it. I know it works.
So then you got back into the garment.
When I started, this more fabric savvy and fabric savvy came about because I was doing the show on Home and Garden So Perfect. And people were sending garments there and saying, what's wrong with this? And I realized, you know, people don't know that needles are very important today, presser feet, they didn't know about the interfacing.
Right.
And I thought, you know, if I wrote a book like this, this would be the kind of book I would refer to. So I started writing it. It took me 3 years. And I
well,
would
101 different fabrics.
And what I do is every week I would take a... I'd get a fabric and I would tame it. You know, I'd fit it in with my other jobs, but I'd... You know, what kind of, how do you pre-shrink it? Some are different than others.
For example, pleated fabrics. How to pre-shrink it, layout, marking, cutting, needle size, needle type.
And, you know, if you want things to look like ready-to-wear, you have to use ready-to-wear techniques and know what they do.
This should be a Bible to everybody's
sewing
room.
Anybody who sews clothes, garments, or anything. You do need this book, I have to say. All right.
And then you got, this must have been a big one, tub of fast fit.
This was spiral binding, but I think Totten doesn't want to do so many anymore. They did some. This was fitting, and people would say, oh, I just wish you could tell me what my fitting issues are. So I thought, well, I can't be everywhere. So then I started describing it. I'd say, here's the one, broad back, the problem. The back of your garments are tight, the back armhole seams rip out, then you have broad back. And then that's what you do to solve it. And I felt like photos don't lie, and this is exactly what I did. So I did that one, and I thought I was finished. I was tired out.
And then you took a little sleep.
Yes.
And then she woke up, and she decided to do two more books. Toolbox 1 and 2, Power Sewing.
Well, these actually started out as I would start teaching things, and people would say, what book is that in? And I said, it's not in a book. Oh, and I thought, oh, no, I have to do another book. And I want, because I wanted a book to have step-by-step and photos that you could really see what you were doing. You know, start, okay, here's what we're doing. This is how it starts. And go through it step-by-step, not missing. These will be kind of classics. You and know, I think you'll really love
and
them.
And what I love about this, too, a lot of one-liners, like little tips here and there, everything from marking and pressing. You know, not really detailed stuff. And what did we do? What did you do with the detailed stuff?
Then, yeah, and then that. A lot of things, I think, are easier to see on a DVD. So I took some of the hard things, and we took some of our shows, and we put those on there, so you get that with it. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's pretty, a lot of stuff.
This is really neat, too. You got the elastic happening
here. Oh, so you
here,
keep
so
your page.
You keep your page, and you can reference to something else, and then you flip back. But look at the, oh, who is that looking so cute?
Let's not have it by the old picture. You know, I thought, if these are my last books, I want everything just the way I want it to be. And so what I did is I made them spiral bound, hardback, open flat, put the DVD in there, and I'm so happy with them. I really am. So, you know, if you want any of these, they're on the Power Sewing website, and these are just like your little resource library.
They are.
I made these books for you.
And you can find all of these books on the Power Sewing website.
So what do you think?
About what?
Power Sewing.